The song that you just heard, an interesting choice for an Easter morning, is from the grandfather of all disaster movies, one called The Poseidon Adventure, released in 1974, I believe. The young woman, by the way, who sings that song, by the name of Maureen McGovern, had never sung anything professionally before that song. She was the secretary working for the production company and was asked by the producer to give her voice for the song. She went on to a long and lustrous career as a singer. There's Rising from the Ashes. But in the story of The Poseidon Adventure, you have a series of characters who are seeking to survive the capsizing of a major ocean liner turned upside down, and they have to climb up through the flaming wreckage all the way up from the first class area of the ship hanging in the water to the stern propeller area upside down. A 2-day or 3-day ordeal in which many of them lost their lives. You have a twisted preacher, you have a hard-bitten cop and his prostitute wife, you have a Jewish philanthropist and his wife on their way to the Middle East, you have some children, you have a whole eclectic mix of people trying to work their way through the darkness to find their way out of this upside down flaming tomb. And eventually 4 of them survive and come out to new life. And this is the song that ends that movie about there's got to be a morning after, there's got to be a way through the darkness, there's got to be a new way to come into the sunlight. And I would use that in every sense of the word for our human condition as we try to make sense of Easter. Only I would change the word sunlight to sunlight, only changing one vowel from a U to an O. On the screen is a picture with many colors, faded through, an image of Jesus standing looking over a horizon with the words, I am. A long time before he lived, one of the great prophets of his people, a great leader, Moses, had an experience with God in which, when challenging God as to who God was given the answer, I am. I am. And emblazoned across this image of Jesus is the word, I am. What does all this have to do with one another? God basically told Moses a very simple message. I am who I am. And if you take all of the commands he gives to Moses, it's to go out into the world and to live beyond the reputation you have acquired, that of a criminal, of a person who has lost their way, who has a false identity, more than one type in your life. Moses, of course, raised as a Pharaoh's prince when he was actually a Hebrew boy, gets angry, murders someone, is on the run, takes an assumed identity, marries for convenience, and in that situation in his life has the experience of God when God says, I am who I am. I want you to be who you are. I'm telling you to be you and go and live and lead my people. This is the one who stands at the beginning of the story that culminates with Jesus of Nazareth. The story of the Hebrew people and their relationship with God. A people that lose their way and will try to literally crucify God. And Jesus of Nazareth, who we claim to be, acknowledge to be, and own to be the Son of God, God incarnate in human form, takes on all of this in our life. Takes all of it to himself and gives it up. and then steps out of the tomb and basically proclaims to the world, I am. Now, you be you. Be yourself. I said more than once from this pulpit, our faith is not to change the world. It's to change us. And if the collective us, being ourselves and owning our relationship with God and what God can do in our life with hope, grace, peace, and love, if we change the world, that's a bonus. That's a good thing. But it doesn't begin with an intent to change the world. It begins with an intent to accept ourselves as who we are, God's beloved child, worthy of grace and truth and life, worthy of sunshine and flowers. And I acknowledge this is really difficult for people to understand. People don't get Easter. They don't get the concept of a person dying and then coming back to life. It seems too magical and mysterious. Man, it is so much easier to believe that a rabbit will lay colored eggs. Seriously. Think about it. There's a really simple message to Easter. So simple it escapes everyone, including myself sometimes. God loves us. God looks at us and says, I see you. Be yourself. You know, I look at my daughter and I want, oh, why can't you be more whatever? And then I look, no, you're not that. You're you. You're who? As a dad, I can look at her and go, be yourself, sweetheart. Just be yourself and feel a sense of wholeness. But by the time we get to be our age, and we look at our kids, usually we're already thinking that we're not good enough. That we've been taught from our early days to, oh, do you remember the one, children should be seen and not heard? I was the father, I'm the bane of my father's existence, who thought I should go to church and be seen and not heard. And I got to tell you that every Easter morning I walk into church, and I'm now an older man with children, and I'm a minister, and I walk into church on Easter morning, and I still regret that the ladies aren't wearing hats. Because as a kid, I used to take a pea shooter to church and try to shoot those hats. Be yourself. Be you. Celebrate who you are, all of it. The good, the bad, the ugly, the beautiful, the joyous. Because this is what Christ rose for. Rose that we could experience in life. I really do embrace bunnies that lay colored eggs, and every year in my home, it's an Easter tradition to watch the movie Hop, where a man becomes the Easter bunny, simply because it's about life. It's not sacrilegious or anti-Christian to celebrate life and love and hope and belief. Because that's what Easter is about. It's about accepting the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, the salvation of the human race that we can actually live and not run around feeling sad about who we are. We do enough of that. So on this Easter, understand there is a morning after. There's a morning after every trauma you will live through. There's a morning after every sorrow you will experience. There's a morning after every hope that is dream that is dashed. There's a morning after every relationship that has faltered or failed. There's a morning after every situation you'll ever find yourself in. And that morning after always raises you into the sunlight, the true light of love and life and hope. Because that's Easter. And by the way, in case you never noticed it, in Scripture it says, you shall keep the Sabbath and keep it holy. That's Saturday, folks. The Sabbath day was Saturday. And it was the day of rest and peace. The reason we have Sunday isn't because it's the Sabbath, because it's the recreation every week of a little Easter. It's the first day of the week to begin the week with a sense of life and hope and a morning after. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.